Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving into a topic that affects millions of people around the world, diabetes.
That's right, and we'll keep it fun and easy to understand. Frankie, I bet you can't guess what diabetes is.
Oh, I know this one, Bart. Diabetes is when you, don't have enough sweet treats?
Close, but not quite. Diabetes is actually when your body can't turn food into energy properly. Normally, your body needs this thing called insulin to unlock cells and turn food into energy.
Ah, insulin, the magical key. So Bert, tell us more. What's insulin really?
Insulin is a hormone. It's like a messenger in your body. Imagine it as a key that opens up your cells, letting in glucose, which is the energy your body needs.
So without insulin, the food we eat just hangs out in our blood, making our blood sugar too high?
Exactly. And when blood sugar gets too high, that's where diabetes comes in. Some people's bodies don't make insulin at all, and others can't use it properly. We call these type 1 and type 2 diabetes.
Type 1 and type 2? Huh? Like player 1 and player 2 in a game?
In type 1 diabetes, the immune system mistakenly attacks the cells in the pancreas that make insulin. So people with type 1 need insulin every day to stay alive.
Wow, that's serious. So type 1 is like a teammate turning on you.
Great analogy, Frankie. And in type 2, the cells are like no entry to insulin. They build up resistance, and over time, the body stops making enough insulin.
So the cells are like bouncers. They won't let insulin in. Got it.
Speaking of insulin, let's talk about where it comes from. The pancreas.
Ah, the pancreas. I always thought it sounded like some kind of vegetable. Isn't it like a corn cob?
It does kind of look like a corn cob. It's about 6 inches long, and it sits right behind your stomach. The pancreas makes insulin and another hormone called glucagon. Plus, it helps break down food with these things called enzymes.
So the pancreas is like the food factory of the body.
Pretty much. It turns food into energy and helps the body use the nutrients from what we eat. Without it, diabetes can get out of control.
All right, Bird. How do people treat diabetes?
Great question, Frankie. For type 1 diabetes, insulin is a must. People have to take it every day, usually with a shot or an insulin pump.
Ouch! So lots of shots?
Yeah, but there are also blood glucose meters and monitors to help people keep track of their blood sugar. And people with type 2 diabetes often start with a medicine called metformin, which helps the cells open up to insulin again.
So there's hope to keep blood sugar under control. That's awesome.
Since we keep talking about insulin, did you know it was discovered over 100 years ago?
Whoa, really? People needed insulin even back then?
Yes. Before the discovery, people with type 1 diabetes usually didn't live long after their diagnosis. But in 1921, a team discovered insulin and changed everything.
That's incredible. Insulin's been a hero for a century.
Absolutely. It was one of the biggest breakthroughs in medicine, especially for people with type 1 diabetes.
All right, Bert, serious question. How do people with diabetes find support?
Glad you asked, Frankie. Support is super important. Many people with diabetes connect through groups like Children with Diabetes and go to events called Friends for Life conferences.
Sounds like a party. A party where everyone gets each other. That's awesome.
Exactly. When people with diabetes connect, they can learn, share stories, and support each other, making diabetes easier to handle.
Okay, Bert, here's a weird fact for you. Did you know that back in 1674, doctors would drink urine to check for diabetes?
No way! Why on earth would they do that?
Apparently, they thought the sweet taste of urine could signal diabetes. It was one doctor's wild experiment that led scientists to understand more about diabetes.
That's both gross and fascinating. We sure have come a long way since then.
Well, we learned a lot today, from how insulin is like a key to those weird old school tests for diabetes.
And we hope you all learned something too. Diabetes might sound complicated, but understanding it is the first step to supporting those who live with it.
If you liked hanging out with us and learning these fun facts, hit that like button and subscribe for more.
And remember, knowledge is powerful and sometimes funny.